nervous system. So when I say enteric, enteric means I'm talking about the stomach region. And when I say nervous system, all of us know what nervous system means. So enteric nervous system is basically classified into two things or two plexuses. One is the myenteric plexus and the other one is the submucosal plexus. So there are two plexuses. One is myenteric plexus and the other one is submucosal plexus. So the myenteric plexus also called as plexus of Auerbach. When I say the word plexus, what comes up to your mind? Plexus is basically a connection or a juncture where different nerves are intersecting. There is type of an intersection of nerves and intersection of nerves with the blood vessels. So it's a site of interaction of all the nerve endings and the blood vessels. That point is called as plexus. Okay. So let's come back to the point, the division of the enteric nervous system, which means what are the nerves which are basically controlling the process of digestion or controlling the process of breakdown of food, fastening the digestion process, slowing down the digestion process, who is directing the body to do more digestion when not to do digestion. So basically that is enteric nervous system. Enteric nervous system could be classified as the myenteric plexus and the submucosal plexus. Myenteric plexus also called as Auerbach plexus. Myenteric comes from the word myo, which means muscle. Okay. So, now let's break it down into following parts of how are they controlling the digestion process. Okay. We have heard two points. There are myenteric and submucosal plexuses. So, myenteric plexus is giving out information they are basically communicating to each other also. So whatever is happening here would be communicated to this part also with the help of interneurons. Okay. Together it is called as enteric nervous system. So the submucosal plexus with the help of motor neurons is connected to the mucosal epithelium, and the myenteric plexus is being controlled or is controlling the longitudinal and the circular muscles of the stomach. We have longitudinal and circular muscles in the stomach, which is helping in the process of digestion, which is basically helping in the throwing the food, moving the food. So they're helping in that. And the submucosal plexus is connected to the mucosal epithelium. Together they are exchanging information with the help of interneurons. So where is interneurons receiving information from? They are receiving information from the autonomic nervous system and the central nervous system. So now let's look into the process. Enteric nervous system, being called as the brain of gut or the brain of stomach, is operating by two manners. One, they are receiving information from autonomic nervous system, like in the case of a sympathetic nervous system or parasympathetic nervous system prevailing, that when the food digestion has to be stimulated, when the food digestion has to be suppressed. Okay, this is what the ANS giving out information. Then CNS, when you are voluntarily thinking of consuming food. So any of this prevailing would give out a stimulus to the interneurons, which is controlling both the plexuses. So now these nerve and blood vessel juncture would be controlling the mucous epithelium to release the mucus, controlling the longitudinal and stomach to perform the process of peristalsis. So these things would be stimulated or inhibited depending about what kind of information they are receiving and what is prevailing in which plexus would be conveyed to each other with the help of interneurons. So basically what is coming through here is that in case of the parasympathetic nervous system, the vagus nerve, which is nerve number 10, is increasing or stimulating the process of digestion. So whenever the digestion prevails, this nerve number 10, which is giving out information to the ENS, which is the brain of the gut, to stimulate this process. And whenever the sympathetic nervous system is prevailing, it is giving out information to suppress the process, because whenever there is a condition of fear, And whenever there's a condition of flight, fight, fright responses, it is all suppressing the entire digestion process. So this is what is happening here. So any kind of a stretch reflexes which is felt by the CNS, when you are voluntarily consuming food, then CNS would be stimulating this. See, it's, I mean, you have to look on this one. Now let me give a brief of how the ANS and CNS would be controlling it differently. If I say CNS, so how is CNS doing things? CNS is, you are voluntarily eating food, fine. That means whenever you are eating food, there is a stretch receptor which is receiving the sense of stretch in the mouth and the esophagus, because obviously the food is entering in. So these are stretching, the stretch receptors are feeling that, and they are conveying a positive impulse that yes, the digestion has to begin. Okay, this is what you are voluntarily doing. And what is the other case which is happening in the case of a parasympathetic nervous system? Sorry, in the case of an autonomic nervous system, either it is SNS which is prevailing, or it is PNS which is prevailing. If SNS which is prevailing, that is sympathetic control, or a parasympathetic control, the sympathetic control would be suppressing the digestion process. It would be stimulating the digestion process. This is stimulating. So this is happening here. If they are receiving an impulse of suppressing the digestion, that means this must be prevailing, and they are not giving out any information, or maybe they are giving information to decrease the digestion process, decrease the release of enzymes. This is giving out information to increase the release of enzymes, to improve digestion, to increase digestion, to stimulate the process of digestion. In the case of CNS, it is, you are voluntarily eating food, then the stretch receptors are conveying out information that yes, the food has entered, is beginning to enter, and the juices are being released. And this is all being conveyed with the help of nerves, with the help of blood vessels which are giving out certain hormones and enzymes to stimulate this process. And this is what is being controlled by the ENS, which we have previously discussed, that they are giving out information to the circular muscles to increase the digestion by performing more peristalsis. In the case of CNS also, they are giving out information to the stomach to increase the process of peristalsis. And in the other case, they are also increasing the mucosal epithelium to release more mucus, Here they are giving the information to the mucosal epithelium. If you look into the previous diagram which I mentioned, that Myentrich and the submucosal plexus were controlling the mucus release, and they were controlling the longitudinal and circular muscles. So in this case, they are suppressing both, suppressing the release of mucus, suppressing the muscles to perform the peristaltic movement. So this is how the enteric nervous system, which is the brain of the gut, is helping in the digestion process to function. So in next lecture, I will be discussing about of how the stomach anatomy looks like. Thank you.